हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज, राजगढ़, अलवर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द पोयम प्रिल्यूड विच इज़ इन द सिलेबस ऑफ बीए पार्ट थर्ड इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर फर्स्ट यूनिट ए। This is my fourth video lecture on this poem. First of all, I read the poem. You tossed a blanket from the bed. You lay upon your back and waited. You dozed and watched the night revealing the thousand sordid images of which your soul was constituted. They flickered against the ceiling, and when all the world came back and the light crept up between the shutters and you heard the sparrows in the gutters, you had such a vision of the street as the street hardly understands. Sitting along the bed's edge, where you curled the papers from your hair or clasped the yellow soles of feet in the palms of both soiled hands. Now I explain you the word meanings. Tossed. Tossed means throw away. Dozed means sleepy state. Revealing means disclosing. Sordid means dirty or unpleasant. Constituted means made up. Flickered means lighted. Crept up means came silently. Shutters means gates. Sparrows are the house birds. Bed's edge means corner of the bed. Curled means putting in a curly shape. Clasped means held up. Or soiled means dirty. These lines have been taken from the third section of Preludes, presenting some of the sordid scenes of the metropolitan town. Here the poet is focusing upon the figures of an unclean woman who wakes up and lies on her back in the sleepy mood. The poet shows the woman contemplating upon the last evening's experiences. These lines of the third prelude present the picture of a woman. In the first line, you stands for the figure of a dirty woman. Perhaps she went to bed without taking a bath at night. Her hands, feet and body was unclean. She awakes. She does not get up or sit down on the bed at once. She throws away her blanket from the bed. She still lies on her back and she appears to be having a mild doze. She is thinking of her sordid experiences of night, which compose her inner life. Then they flashed for a moment like the lantern lights on the ceiling and vanished as the light crept into the room between the gates of the room, and the ear was regaled by the sound of the sparrows, the house birds, brawling in the gutters. The woman sits up at the corner of her bed. She curls the papers from her hair and grabs the yellow sole of her feet with the palms of both her dirty hands. Then the woman begins to think of the trampled street outside the conjured up an street like a vision of it. The vision is described in the last prelude. This woman imagines that the road is like a woman who is trampled by innumerable men. The dirty street is like the unclean woman stretched on her back and passively enduring the pressures of men mounted on her. In this way, the street, like the woman, faces the day with a blackened conscience. So, the woman wakes up and throws her blanket from the bed. She lies on the back and waits. Soon she dozes and in her short nap watches various sordid scenes and experiences she had undergone last night. Last night's activities flicker as if in the form of a slide on the ceiling or the roof of her home. Soon the whole world awakens. The morning light is seen from the cracks of the shutters or gates of her room. Soon sparrows, the birds, are twittering in the street gutters. The dreams of the woman are such as nobody else can understand. She thinks of these scenes while uncurling her hair from paper curls or while holding her soles in her palms. So, according to T.S. Eliot, Metropolis is by no means a very attractive place. It is sordid, grim, and most unattractive. Even the vision of the woman are not constituted on a romantic visions. The woman's love is not romantic. It merely aims at satisfying sexual lust. So in the next video lecture, I will explain you the fourth section of the prelude. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.